Alright, Mr. Nygren here. So, I'm playing Warhammer, Beginning of the End Times. It's version 1.1, but I am using... So it's the version, the first version that released in 2016 during the summer. But I'm using my personal submod for it, that I originally named Expanded Elves Edition, because it replaces the entire Dark Elven faction and the entire High Elven faction with the factions from the Sundering, while also keeping some of the models from Beginning of the End Times that I liked, and using a lot of the old models as armor variations. So it has like a huge variation in different units and models being used for the High Elves and Dark Elves. For example, the Dark Elves have a lot of officers too, because there were like 7 different variations of certain units, like for example the Bleak Swords or the Dark Shards. There might have been up to 7 different models for them. And as you can only have 4 armor upgrades, you have the first one and then 3 upgrades, Bronze, Silver and Gold. After that you can't upgrade anymore. And there were like 7 models. I used the ones that were left over as officers. Alright, and also I've changed the Britonnia faction and the Wood Elven faction too, because they severely lacked units in this version of Warhammer Beginning of the End Times. So I've added the units from Sundering. There were like 2 units from the Sundering for Britonnia and 1 unit for the Wood Elves. However, I also added the female units for Avalorn, which is an High Elven faction, Wood Elven, High Elven faction. I thought it was Wood Elven, because they use 3 kins and stuff, dryads and such. But I'm gonna remake this mod before releasing it, and I plan to replace the Hydra from the Sundering, the Manticore from the Sundering, and a lot of the other monsters with stuff from the alternative cut, because I have permission to use those, but I don't have permission to use the Sundering. I haven't gotten a no from the Sundering, but I haven't gotten a yes either. You know, it's been impossible to reach out to the team behind the Sundering. They have been gone for years. They were active in 2012, and trying to find them or write to them now is pretty much impossible. So I don't have their written permission, and it's unclear if they allowed people to, you know, make submods and release them. Also, this isn't a submod of the Sundering. This is a submod of Beginning of the End Times, and I have permission from Tom Doof and the other guy, Wiff of something, to make a submod out of the Beginning of the End Times. So I also have permission to use alt cut assets, but I don't have written permission to use Sundering assets, and this mod is mainly focused on, you know, replacing Beginning of the End Times models with Sundering models. So I plan on replacing the Giant Beasts with alt cut versions or Beginning of the End Times versions, because the Beginning of the End Times didn't have Hydras in the past. Now they do. And same with Griffins and other stuff, Eagles and such. Now they have all that, so I will use the Beginning of the End Time stuff instead. As for the actual units, I believe a lot of them were from the original Warhammer. There might be 1 or 2 that are Sundering unique, but those models, they are from Warhammer Online, and I believe Games Workshop allowed anyone to use the Warhammer Online models, so I don't know. It's unclear whether or not I can use them or not, because Games Workshop has allowed anyone to use them, but I haven't gotten written permission from the modders who actually rigged the models. But to be honest, it would be the same model if you took them from Warhammer Online and rigged them yourself. The only difference is that someone else rigged them here. It would still be the same model anyway, because it's taken from Warhammer Online. So, I don't know. But anyway, we will continue this campaign. I started it in January 2018 and played for like 7 episodes. Then I tired, because I realized I couldn't release it. then I decided to go back to it and play during the summer of 2018 when I started to play a lot of my mods like The Last Kingdom, Wrath of the Norsemen, Warcraft Total War, and this mod, and Lord of the Rings Total War, which I haven't worked on, but it's a great mod. And that's for Rome Total War Alexander. The others are for Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms. And now I decided to go back to this because I want to continue the campaign. It's pretty epic. I have moved the game to Steam, so I can use the third person mod now and control the generals in third person, including Malekith himself on a dragon, because in this version of Beginning of the End Times they used dragons as cavalry, as horse cavalry, well, in the later versions they are elephants. The difference is that if you have horse cavalry they can be up to 14 units with officers, while with the elephant cavalry they can only be like 3 and also or 4. And also elephant cavalry can't have riders, while the with the exception of you know, javeliners or archers on those like towers they wear, if they are elephants, but they can't have riders like the horses, they can't ride them, and that means we can't have Malekith riding a dragon in the later Beginning of the End Times mods, but in this version he is riding a dragon together with his bodyguard, and that's possible because they are horses. But that also means horses can't attack, so they can't attack in melee. It's always the rider that is attacking using the sword or lance, and then the dragons won't be able to spit fire either when they are horses. So in order to have proper dragons you need to have them as elephants. But I like that he is riding the dragons. It's pretty cool to control him in real time as well. Alright, we will start the battle. I don't think I will bother with the third person mod. I did play this battle and two other battles with the third person mod. I believe I played this and the one with Morathi, where she is attacking city of Lothern, the capital of the High Elves, which is now under siege. Let's exit this for a second. If we go down here, you can see that we are still using the old Beginning of the End Times map that has cut Ultan in half. And there is no path between Lustria and the Dark Elves, with the exception of by sea, which works badly in the game. It's better to have a land connection between areas so they can move to each other. That's a good change in the later versions of Beginning of the End Times, but in this version the areas are disconnected by sea. Of course I can use ships to move troops, but in most mods they won't do that because if the continents are too far from each other then they won't do it, but I believe they are hopefully close enough for them to do that. I saw in the other version in Alt-Cat that Tilly actually sent a fleet with an army to Lustria, so it's a high chance they can do that here too. So we have an army here, High Elven army, using the Lothern Sea Guard from the Sundering and High Elf Spears from the Sundering. This one has an armor upgrade, so it's a different model than the others. We have two High Elf Spears with the bronze upgrade. We have Lothern Sea Guard basic level, okay. Then we are besieging the city of Lothern, capital in this mod of the High Elves. We have the enemy general, Azor Prince Tyrion there. He has a High Elf bodyguard, which it's a horse unit from the Sundering. He has the Warriors of Blackwood with the bronze upgrade, High Elf Spears with bronze upgrade, and the High Elf Archers with a bronze upgrade. And this Morathi herself, mother of Malekith, the Witch King, who is besieging the city of Lothern. She has a bodyguard of Dark Elf sorceresses. They look the best in this mod because they are from the Sundering, and the sorceresses of the Sundering are the best looking by far. Alright, we have the Dread Spears basics. We have Witch Elves of Cain, all the unit portraits with the exception of some units that were in the Beginning of the End Times, like the Demonets of Slaanesh and the Anaconda's Amazons, they are from the Sundering. I replaced others. If I release this mod, I will return the portraits to the Beginning of the End Times portraits, or make my new portraits for these characters. I will probably make new ones. And I will remove Sundering unique units, like for example the Manticore here will be removed and replaced with the Manticore of Altcat, and the Dragons of the Sundering will be removed because they have ugly animations. I will rather use the Beginning of the End Times Dragon. I think it's the best one. Altcat has a new dragon, and the Beginning of the End Times version 2.0 has also a new dragon. I prefer the look of the dragon from Beginning of the End Times 2.0. They look different from the dragons in this version, which is Beginning of the End Times 1.1. They are smaller and less likely to crash, and they work much better. They can move their tail, they can move their head, etc. Much better animations for them. When they fly, they have their legs aren't pointing down. They actually are forced up like they would if they were flying. So it looks much better in the new versions than in this version. Also, the dragons I ported from Sundering, they have the old animations where they fly without moving the wings, and they are pretty much just a model in the air that can't move. I don't want to use that anymore. It's the same in Game of Thrones Enhanced, another mod I worked on from Medieval Two Kingdoms. Those dragons that are outdated from the Sundering, they will be removed. All the portraits will be remade, or I will use the Beginning of the End Times portraits, but I think I will remake them for at least the specific units that look different here. And the Manticores, etc., they will be replaced with, and the Hydra, etc., they will be replaced with the ones in the Beginning of the End Times 2.0, first of all. And if they aren't there, I will use the Altcat to replace them. Because I want Manticores and I want Hydras, but I don't necessarily need the Sundering ones. They are the worst ones. They don't have as cool animations. Then we have different Cold One Knights. The new, the old version, the 1.1 version here, has the old Cold Ones that I used in Warcraft as well before we got the new Raptors. They have no animations. They are pretty much camels with a new model. But the new version 2.0 is using awesome new animations for them, so they actually move their mouths up and down, and they move their tail, and they run like actual Cold Ones. In this mod we have a different Cold One altogether. There are two versions, the ordinary Cold One, which is using a red like Cold One. It's the same model in use for the Carnosaur in Beginning of the End Times, so I won't use that model because it's the Carnosaur, they just made it bigger. So they got away with using the same model there, but remade it in terms of its size and made it the Carnosaur instead. But then there is the veteran one, used by the generals, and it is using like Dark Elven gear and stuff. I like that model, so I might use it, or I might use the one from Beginning of the End Times because it has cool animations. This one has different animations too, but it doesn't move the mouth, etc., but it moves the legs. Anyway, let's continue. So Morathi herself is attacking Lothern, and I've played this battle before without recording when I tried the third person mod. I might use the third person mod, then we can control Morathi in third person. We'll see about that. So we have some spies here. Let's move up here. Let's put on the fast forward there. So we can look at these units here. We have High Elf Archers, basic level. We have the Warriors of Blackwood with bronze upgrade. And we have the High Elf Spears here, basic level. So nothing special. Then we have High Elf Spears with bronze upgrade and Warriors of Blackwood with the bronze upgrade. So mostly used sucky troops from the High Elves. They didn't start with great troops, only some generals had good stuff. Krazan Lion Chariots, so they have a good unit here with the bronze upgrade. The Dark Elves didn't start with too many good units either, but I believe they had better units from the start than the High Elves. Or I try to be kind of equal. I try to give the High Elves a lot of, you know, dragons and griffins, etc., as general bodyguards and such. But at the end of the day, I think the High Elves, as the AI, is doing a bad job and not really recruiting the best stuff. we might play the High Elves later. So we have Hellebrand Air here. Let's move her into Torrivres. Actually, we can move her up there. And move towards the city. Move the ships there. We will keep the ships there as well. We have some battles to fight. Let's take a look at the recruitment. Have I done the recruitment? How many cities have we, do we have? We have 11 cities. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We've done that. And here we could actually recruit some stuff in the Shrine of Cain. I think I will go for some. Let's see here. 5,000. Let's go for some Witch Elves of Cain. In Caron Car. I believe we will replace the Cauldron of Blood too. It's the beginning of the end times one. I believe the one from Sundering is better. We'll see about that. Or more badass looking. But let's see here. The mages here are very, very costly. 16,000 for the sorceresses. So you won't buy them. I've remade all the gameplay here for the High Elves and the Dark Elves and the Wood Elves and the Britonnian faction too. So they have very costly mages. They have different stats, etc. Alright, let's see what we can recruit. I think we could go for a priest in Caron Can. I do want a merchant too. You don't need a diplomat. You don't need a spy. Let's go for Witch Elves of Cain. And maybe we could go for some Black Art Corsairs and some Harpies. Alright. In Claire Carond, we will get the priest, and we already had a priest, but we could use one inside of the city too. We could go for the demonettes are pretty costly. We could go for the dread spears, and yeah, let's just go for dread spears there. Then in Harganet, we could go for some dread spears as well. And in Ghrond, yeah, I don't have a problem with that. So we don't have a lot of money left. Wait with that, we will do the priest and one unit of dread spears. And in Hagraeth, we could simply go for some reapers like that. And we're done, we can't recruit anything more. Let's attack. So the enemy, the rebels, they have 3 units of Marauder Axe Throwers, and they have some Marauder Desolators. Also, I let's see here. They have Curse Marauder Horsemen as their bodyguard. So we are ready to fight the battle. Let's fight the battle on the battle map. Start deployment. As we can see, we have Dreadlords and black dragons here. They are much bigger here, the dragons. More prone to CTD probably, but they are still pretty stable. So we have the Nagarith officer here. Some kind of what should I say? symbol of their past. Then we have an officer, and we have another like officer guy here from Sundering. We see the models look more badass from Warhammer Online. And then we have Malekith himself. It's the same model as the other one with a longer sword, so I think it's better looking. So if we use the third person mod, we could actually control Malekith in battle on the dragon, but we won't do that now. Let's see what we can do here. We'll group in all the infantry. All of these guys were infantry. We had one long range unit, the Reapers there. Right, and the Nets could have Chanting on. Same with Anaconda's Amazons and the Witch Elves' ability curse. So all of them, even the Harpies had that. Alright, let's take a look at the army. So we have Daemonettes of Slanese here, from the beginning of the End Times. We have the Black Ark Corsairs, the first variation, probably the Assassin model in the Sundering. And a unit from Warhammer Online, because all the models in the Sundering are from Warhammer Online. We have the Witch Elves and the Reapers here. Actually, I will move the Reapers forward. They should be at the front. They are archers, so they look like this. Also a Sundering Warhammer Online model. We have the Witch Elves of Cain. Unlike the ones in the beginning of the End Times 2.0, 5.something and 5.5, I believe, and Alcat, they are not having white hair here. Like in the original beginning of the End Times, they have black hair. However, there are two versions of the model. This is the basic one. It's the high quality one with more of a white body color. Then there's the Sundering one, which is the same with a more red glowing body. They look more like they have recently been battered in blood or something. I don't know which one I prefer, but if I remake the mod, I will use the one with white hair for the fourth armor upgrade, and then use the black haired ones for the early, I believe. Alright, we have the Harpies. They have two different looks. This is the one from the beginning of the End Times. They look more, what should I say, beautiful, while the other ones are more like beasts. And then we have the Anaconda's Amazons. Alcat, they have made the entire faction out of this unit, an entire faction. It's very cool. I want to play a campaign with them later. And the Amazons, but in this game they are simply a mercenary unit, and I made it recruitable from the cities for the Dark Elves. But I will remake that, because I originally only wanted them to have one of these recruitable at any one time. But unfortunately, they can recruit an unlimited number from any time, from any town, I believe, or it's like one from each town, but that's not intended. As you can see, I have two units of Anaconda's Amazon. They're supposed to be limited, because when you recruit them on the map, you can't recruit more unless that unit is killed. I believe that's the case. Anyway, we will probably remove them from the recruitment later. But in this campaign, they are recruitable. I like females, so that's fine. And we have the leader with his unit. It's an early version. It's the silver version, the third, actually. So it looks like this, their third variation. An old model, but with lances. Alright, let's start the battle. And pause the game. The enemy army, the Chaos Rebels here, the Raiders. So they have some axe throwers, I see. Let's just move the archers up to confront them. And yeah, we could send some infantry against them. Actually, we won't send a Dark Elven unit. We'll send Anaconda's Amazons to handle those guys. And lose formation for them all. That's it. Now they have some infantry in the back. Let's send the Black Ark Corsairs against those guys. They are tougher. And the Daemonites of Slanese will fight the Chaos stuff there too. We had a mounted unit in the back there. But we will send the Harpies against the infantry as well. Unfortunately, they do not fly in this game. They just run. But I believe in Hyrule Total War, there is the perfect animation for Harpies that will make them fly and move down and then fight on foot. But then every time they move, they will fly, etc. I should seriously consider porting that animation for the Harpies. Would be great. We have a mounted Chaos Marauders unit here, throwing javelins and stuff. We will move the dragons towards that unit, because it's a horse cavalry unit. We don't have any other cavalry unit in this army. Alright, and the Witch Elves of Cain would also be moved against the infantry there. And this Anaconda's Amazon unit. Yeah, let's just attack those guys. So, we're done. And kill them with pleasure. Your troops fight better. That's the ability of Malekith the Witch King himself. We won't use that now. Let's wait a second. You shouldn't move too fast here. So the dragons, when they walk, they move like this, and when they run, they fly. That means when you control Malekith in third person, you can run and you can... I mean, you can walk and you can fly. So, this music, I seem to remember it from somewhere. Don't think it's necessarily Warhammer music. Alright, so the Daemonettes of Slanese are first in line. Now it's Warhammer music, I think. Alright, maybe I'm wrong, maybe it all is Warhammer music. But it sounded slightly different. I like the black haired Witch Elves. I think they look younger. I mean, we're sure they are hags and witches, so giving them white hair like the official Total War Warhammer 2 game makes sense in a way. They are evil too, but I like when they're hot and young. So when they are black haired in the tabletop games, the figures, etc., in the books, so yeah, I think they look better and younger with black hair. That's why I think this model is better than the other one. But I still use the white-haired ones for their fort upgrade, because they could be used as some kind of veteran version. The Daemonettes of Slanese have reached the infantry army there, the Chaos Faction. The Witch Elves are now also joining, as well as the Black Ark Corsairs. Attack. Just attack. Attack these guys. The Reapers have started to fire their arrows at the axe throwers over there. Let's move the dragon to side. Sure, when they move over them, they will. It's like they ran right over them, because, like with the cavalry. Let's move up here with Malekith himself. He needs to somehow attack that cavalry unit from the back. And let's use his ability to kill them with pleasure. And kill that cavalry unit now that is throwing javelins at our troops. Dragons will have to take care of it. Proper unit to take care of the horsemen. Good. As for the map, let's zoom in. So we have some melee fighting here against the Chaos Rebels. Would like to move them up. Let's move them back like that and surround them from the back. And just charge, attack. Kill them. Alright, so the dragons are doing a good job against their cavalry. It's getting slaughtered. Of course my cavalry will then run up towards their axe throwers, because I think that the axe throwers are hard to run down for the infantry. We have archers of course, but that's not enough. So we have one here, huh? Yeah, we have one there. The dragons are hunting down their fleeing cavalry there. Right, we are done here. Kill the other ones, but let the cavalry take care of them too. Kill the cavalry, and then the archers could continue to fire at them as well. Use the inspire ability of the general there, Malekith himself. He could only use kill them with pleasure ability once during the battle. Then it becomes an ordinary increase morale ability. So the battle was easily fought and won. I believe the Steam version is less laggy. It works more fluently without any lag, etc. I like the Steam version more in terms of battles, real-time battles. And also it's cool to use that third-person mod that only works with Steam. Alright, so we have won the battle. 67% enemy skill, 70% enemy skill, 90% ally skill. Let's zoom out here. There are some enemies still there. Alright, fuckers. Let's use the Reapers against them. They are already firing at them, it would seem. Alright, let's move the dragons towards those units as well. They are steady, so they are not routing yet. We have an enemy army here too, somewhere. I can't really see them. Alright, they are chanting here. Alright, so we have an enemy army there. Let's hunt that guy down. An axe thrower skirmisher unit. I believe my demonettes of Slaanesh will run him down. Alright, mercy is for the weak. Let's kill those guys. Dragons have done a great job. The archers too, they just killed that final unit. 81% enemies killed, 24.5% allies killed. We still have some enemies alive on the map. Dragons will be sent out here. We have an entire unit here of Marauder Axe Throwers. They are killing my poor units. Kill them. And lose formation so they don't kill you in like this. We lost a lot of our poor Amazons thanks to those Axe Throwers. Actually move back. Run away from there. Everyone stop. Just the dragons will take care of them. Run. Flee from that place. They are killing me. Fuck. Killed almost all my Amazons of this unit. Only 25 left. Infantry isn't good against long range units. Now it's payback. Cavalry is good. So Malekith took care of that unit. Boost the morale there.
Chaos is everywhere.
109 Anacondas Amazons left there. Like the Amazons too. Their faction is really cool. In alternative cut there. Harpies. Alright, we're done here. 93% enemies killed, 100% allies killed. kill everyone, slay them, lose formation, boost the morale of the troops. I just hunt them down so they can't leave the battlefield. Some of them will leave, probably, because the dragons aren't good at hunting units down. We will kill some of them. The rebels are defeated. There will be spawning more of them, probably. I'm sad we lost all of those Anaconda's Amazons, too. Look at the carnage of the Amazons. That was unnecessary. Alright, 94% enemies killed, 30% allies killed. And the battle's over, clear victory. Malekith the Witch King had 926 men. He lost 239, not too many, and troops remained 687. Enemies killed 546, 93 while they were fleeing the battle. Clovis Bluetooth of the Rebels had 694 men and killed 647, so they killed almost as many as they had, which is good for such an army, and they have 47 remaining. Enemies killed. I was wrong. They lost 647 out of their 694. That's really bad, and they killed 277. Alright. Zero while they were running. So none of my units were routing. That's good. Sigmar preserves, but I often put much more trust in the dwarves than I do in my fellow electors. Count Marius, late dwarf of Everland. Nice background picture with the dark elves here and slaves. Alright, and we're done there. Trade increase. Malekith the Witch King feels appreciated. This man is satisfied with his life and faithful to the governor more than ever before. He is the governor. Alright, retinue expands. Malekith the Witch King. An addition has been made to this person's entourage of followers. It is the nature of man to follow more remarkable people. Armor of protection. This simple suit of Sigma of Italmar armor is adorned by a single Solitaire rune on the breastplate. The world dragon itself is said to protect the wearer. +2 command, +2 to public security, improve the chances of detecting and capturing enemy agents. Alright, we're done here. We have another army here. We have the General Crompton Lightbane of the Rebels with Flamers of Teens, Demon Bodyguards. And his units are Horrors of Teens, Demonets of Slanese, and Bloodletters of Khorne. He has 1 Bloodletter, 3 Demonets, and 2 Horrors of Teens. The Bodyguard had Flamers of Scenes, it's another unit. And then they have a Mount Demonettes unit as well. It's a very strong rebel army because demons are strong. We won't attack them. We have limited troops. We will move back to Ghrond and merge the units and try to reinforce the army. Right, think Car on Car. We have some units. Let's move the Demonettes of Slanese. He has some way to go there, but still we will move. And then we have maybe some units we can send from here as well. We have the female units, we will send them. They're pretty strong. From Hagrave we sent a Demonette of Slanese unit and a Witch Elves of Cain unit. Then in Clare Carond we had an entire army. So this means we have 3 units on the move there. And we need to have, I believe we need to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, we need 11 units. We have 3. That means 8 more units are needed. Let's send the Anaconda's Amazons and the Witch Elves. That's 4 units. And then we will send the Dread Spears. That's 6 units. And the Black Orc Corsair, 7 units, and 1 unit of Reapers. That's all we need to send. It will be as So we'll move them up there. For centuries, we have nursed our hatred. Never. Let's make sure they move there, even if I forget to move them at some point. We have some agents probably we can send. We have a merchant here. Priest outside of this area. Clerk Ghrond. Truchy spy. Let's move him up here. See if there are any enemies here. No, there aren't. And you don't need to move the Reapers. They crash the game if there are too many in the battle. They were very numerous. 220 men and high polygons. So yeah. We use them as garrisons if we can. They are also cheap. They only cost 300. We have Hellebron with the two generals Malisfelwind and Morathi Shadowbane moving towards Tower of Whet. Tower of Whet. Morathi Shadowbane seems to be a newbie. Malisfelwind is slightly better. We have Hellebron, very good general. She has to retinue the priest of she's a priest of Cain. Radiant Glam of Huet is an item she has. She has the Dread Banner of the Dark Elves. She has the River Bow, Talisman of Loek, Armor of Stars, the Dragon Crown of Karas. Alright. So the High Elves still hold this area, and then they have an area over here as well. I don't know if they have more areas like Avalorn or something. I don't think so. I think this map didn't have Avalorn. Alright, so we are about to attack, but we still haven't built the towers. We have two rams and the two towers. We haven't built the two final ones. But I don't know if we actually need that. Actually, I think we will attack, to be honest. I'm gonna replay what I already did. Then I would let the AI control the army. I'm not sure I want to do that. I wouldn't let the AI control the entire army. I would still control my cavalry so they won't suicide themselves, and so I can use the bodyguard rider against their cavalry. And then I would keep four units of infantry to handle the rams and the towers, but I would let the rest of the army, the Reaper Bolt Thrower and all the other infantry attack from the AI, because I would control Morathi, the family member, myself. She has also very good skills. She's a sorceress. She's a priest of Cain. She have the Darkstar Cloak. She's a witch brew is this style from Blood by the High Queen's Ash. She has the witch brew. She has the Dread Banner. She has some lion here, more vigilant, intimidating and loyal than even the most cunning of watchmen. Right, she probably earned that. Potion of Vitality, Sword of Wet. Normally this fine blade lies wrapped in silk in the armor of the White Tower, but in time of war it is given to a great hero to wield the name of the lore masters. We probably earned it after a battle, and we killed some general who had it. One high elven general. Alright, so I think we will, it would be cool to use the third person mod, but I will lose more troops if I let AI control most of the army. I think we will, could still do that. Forward. Right, we move that unit. And see here, we will move all the mercenary units and the harpies there as well. We'll also move the Reaper Bolt Thrower there. And I believe I could use the archers. The AI is usually stupid in using such units. We need four units. We keep the Witch Elves of Cain. and move the rest of the infantry to that army there. Trades are missiles, so I won't let the AI control them. We have the Harganet Executioners, they will also be moved. And we have the Cauldron of Blood, they will be moved as well. We have half an army now here, almost half an army. We'll keep the cavalry, and I believe they can have one long range unit. The other one we will keep. They have 11 units now, we should have kept that anyway. The other half we will control it, and yeah, I think this will be it. Right, so let's start the battle. I don't need those towers. However, I need to go and do some business, so see you soon. I will return soon and fight the battle. But for now, we will save the game, and I need to do some stuff. See you soon. So I'm back to play the battle. I think we will use the first person mod in this battle, third person mod. Alright, attempt a night attack. No, we won't, because then the army won't be a part of it. Unfortunately, otherwise, I like the idea of attacking during night, because the Dark Elves are the Dark Elves. It makes sense for them to attack during night. They would probably act in the dark, protected by the night, as dark as they are. But now that I made this army an AI army, I can't do that. We still seem to have the upper hand, but nope, that won't happen. We will attack during the day. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, and start the battle. Fight the battle on the battle map. I love the model of Morathi in this game, in this mod. Alright, so the battle is starting. The walls are custom retextured walls of High Elves, but the cities are vanilla. Of course, if I'm ever gonna release this mod, I will remake this as well. I will use the custom settlements of the alt-cut version, or the textures of the cities from the Sundering, because I don't like vanilla cities. Anyway, in this game only the walls are custom for the High Elves, and the Dark Elves don't have anything custom. Maybe their walls are custom as well, I don't know. I kind of remember they had custom walls, but the cities are vanilla. Alright, start deployment. Also love their voices in this game. They are better than in Total War 1940, in Total War Warhammer 2. Alright, so this is Morathi, wonderful model of Morathi, the mother of Malekith, and her bodyguard of sorceresses, the best looking sorceresses by far. No competition there. Love the hairstyles, the long dresses, etc. And Kolvan Knights, but this model is used in the beginning of the End Times as the Carnosaur for the lizard men. So they used this, they just resized it and made it bigger and gave it new animations. So that's why we won't use it. If we are going to update the mod, I will remove this called one. Because it's the same model as the Carnosaur, so it looks like a baby Carnosaur. So yeah, it won't be used. But on the other hand, the Manticores here are horses, just like the dragons in the beginning of the End Times alternative cut. They are elephants, so they are three instead. They decided to go more like based on the official game. So this unit will be replaced with an elephant unit of three Manticores from alt cut instead. And then the generals have a different version of Kolvan, and that's the one I might actually keep, because it's cool and it looks like a Dark Elven unit. It has gear of a Dark Elven unit and is the right color, etc. This one could of course work as the Kolvan of the Lizardmen and the Amazons or something like that, but it looks too much like the console. Then we have the other units. We have a Shrades unit, and they are the basic Shrade unit, crossbowman unit. Let's place them in loose formation, move them forward, bring them fire at the enemy on the walls there. And we have the Dark Shards, the bronze version, the bronze upgrade. They look like this. Both females and men. You can see the boobs there. Anyway, it's an old model, but it's the second variation. They had lots of different variations of this model. They are also used as the crew of the Reaper Bolt Throwers. Let's put them in loose formation. And place them on the walls. And then we have 128 Witch Elves of Cain, 44 Witch Elves of Cain. They'll be sent in first, they are too few. So they should be sent in first. Smoothies a little closer. The size of the ram. Alright, we're done. Let's put them in loose formation. They were already in loose formation. We will take the siege tower, guarded with Witch Elves of Cain, by Witch Elves of Cain, armor upgrade level 2. Still using this model, very good model. Right, place them there. The ram, the upgrade, they had the basic version. Same model, very wonderful Dark Elven models. Probably the only difference with the ones in 2.0 of Beginning of the End Times and Alternative Cut is that they have white and pink hair there, while here they have black hair. Alright, and loose formation. We have some Witch Elves of Cain, the third armor upgrade. Still looks like the same model. Yeah. I'm pretty sure it's the same model. Yeah, same model for all the three first versions. I didn't have a gold upgrade. We have another one here with a ram, but it's the same. But as you can see, the officers here have the other model. So the difference is that these are whiter, while these have like they look like they have been battered in blood. Also they might be less high resolution. But these ones are from Warhammer Online or the Sundering, and they are used for the what is the name? The Blood Cauldron, the Cauldron of Blood. So these are the Cauldron of Blood versions used in this mod. They are also the fourth upgrade. So when these become the gold upgrade, when these get the gold armor upgrade, they will turn like into these guys. I will change this so that these will still be used as the Cauldron of Blood version, but that will be the only one that will use this, and then the others will look like this. Up until maybe the gold level, where they will get the white hair. So we need to move this unit to the side. Because I need to take out... let's see here, we can't place them there. See, we can't really go there. Closest we could get was here. Place are here. Alright, start the battle. Attack that gate. Let's pause the game. And then we will order these units to attack. We will attack the gate with the ram. We will use the siege towers against the walls there. And then the second siege tower will attack the other walls, the other side of the wall. Right, about the ranged units. I don't know how long range they have. But we will take a look at the wall here. If they have any ranged units, we will attack them. But I don't think they have that. No, they only had spearmen and such. Still, we will attack their walls with our ranged units. We will attack units on the walls. High Elf spears. High Elf spears. And Warriors of the Blackwood. They also have towers, which isn't good. So it didn't take control of the siege engine, but it can't attack walls anyway. It can only attack enemies. They don't have any siege engine against the towers, which is sad. Alright, and then we have the cavalry. They won't act yet. We could move them forward, because I will need them against their cavalry. And the hero could move forward too. So these manticores can fly, but they look kinda weird when they fly. They still run in the air. As for these guys, of course, they work good. The red cold ones would have been perfect for the lizardmen, probably. If they didn't have a carnosaur that looked exactly like that. So we have the dark shards starting to fire here against the troops on the walls. They are firing back at them. We have the shades too with their crossbows. Let's take a look at the allied army. They have some Reaper bolt throwers there. Here's the Cauldron of Blood from beginning of the end times. Might replace it. As you can see, the Witch Elves of Cain are bloodied. They are more bloody looking than the others. Perfect for the Cauldron of Blood. And then we have some Cultists of Cain with the Reaper bolt throwers there. Have the Dread Spears here. Some Bleak Swords. Upgraded Bleak Swords, pretty good looking. Some Harganet Executioners here. Have the Shades with crossbows there. Some more Harpies. Anaconda's Amazons. And more. The Cauldron of Blood here. Nice, I like this model too. Alright, and then we have a unit in the back of six units of Daemonets of Slaanesh and the Captain. The cool model. Character model. So our ram has reached the gate. Damage 34%. Good. And at the other gate, give damage 4% of the gate now. Well, our troops, the Witch Elves of Cain, started to drop down on the walls from the siege towers on both sides of the wall. Their defenders, they have High Elf Archers, upgraded ones here. Pretty good looking. And we have the basic spearmen here. Basic warriors of Blackwood here with their axes. Some zoomed in fighting here. So they both kick and hit with their weapons. So they have the old animations. Some mods, like Elder Scrolls, I believe they remove the kicking and hitting because it doesn't make sense for units to use their fists and legs. They will just use the knives. It's nice to see this view. The Witch Elves there. So, 4%. What are they doing? Ah, the ram is broken. Then I'm afraid you will have to go up the walls through the siege ladder. I mean the siege tower. What about this? We have breached the walls already. Great job. Witch Elves of Cain. As I knew, they had their cavalry here. I don't like that. We will move our cavalry to this side. They will be needed. We will move our Witch Elves back so their cavalry won't come and attack them. I know if I enter the city with the Witch Elves of Cain, then they will send their cavalry bodyguard unit against us. You can see their general here in all his glory. And some officers, Dragon Princess of Kalet or something. And something else. Illyrian Reavers, Dragon Princess. Yeah. Right, and their unit, what its name was, is, I can't check it, they are too far away. It's a cool mount, very armored elven mount. I like the mounts of Warhammer Online. They look very cartoony, very much like the tabletops units, the game. More fantasy-like and less real. But, yeah, look at this. Nice to see them fight in close quarters on the walls here. Alright. So battle on the walls continues. We need our cavalry to move all the way over there. The Manticore riders have already showed up. It's a bodyguard unit. They are used as a unit here. Alright. We have the cold ones coming close behind. Alright, the cold ones will be sent in first, I guess. Or maybe not. I won't waste my cold ones. We will attack with the Manticores against their cavalry. As for the city, what else do they have? They have every unit on the walls. All their units are on the walls here. Mostly basic units. Had one cool unit of High Elven archers with armor, but it seems to be defeated. They had also this unit, it's their best unit, their bodyguard unit. The Manticores will handle that one. They are strong. Let's take a look at their stats. 21 attack, 9 charge bonus, 33 defense. Pretty strong. Also, they have special abilities. Inspire nearby troops, can swim, effective against armor. Frighten nearby troops, excellent morale, powerful charge, can't hide. The reason they can swim is because they can fly, so obviously they should be able to cross rivers with their wings. Alright, and we are closing in on the enemy at the center. We are now close enough to take a look at their stats. They have a High Elf bodyguard, 10 attack, 9 charge bonus, 19 defense. They are weaker. They are more in number than us. They have 56 and we have like 10. Right, and they have inspired nearby troops, frightened nearby enemy infantry, excellent morale, perfect charge, can't hide, very good stamina. Alright. So the Manticores will attack their bodyguard unit. Cavalry versus cavalry, so they can't run down my infantry when they enter the city. So that's good. As for their units, I like these riders, they look good. They look like dreaded. Like evil. I also like the High Elven units here. They look also very good. Including the mount. Very cartoony. Alright, and they have a grittier look than in vanilla beginning of the end times. I believe the models of beginning of the end times are mostly made by the mod creators, while some of them are from the original Call of Warhammer and from Warhammer Online, but Sundering is only using models from Warhammer Online, so that's the difference. And Warhammer Online looked very, very much like the tabletop games. It's good that the Manticores are very strong, so we will win this battle at the center. we're done there. Fortunately, the gate didn't get breached on this side. We need to move Morathi here. So, what are our allies doing? They are soon to enter the city. Good, but these guys have gotten stuck there. The Dread Spears. However, the Black Art Corsairs is about to enter the city. The rest of the infantry army, that's why I needed to take out that cavalry so they wouldn't run all my infantry down. Some of them have already entered. Dread Spears. 128. Good. So they started to move and we breached the gate. And we won it at the center. So we are now in charge of the center of the city. Enemy general fallen, Asher Prince Tyrion is dead. Their prince or king or whatever is dead. Battles on the walls continue. You have a timer, 3:46. You win when the timer has gone down. I believe these are archers. Even though they have spears too. Pretty good. They are routing for some reason, or they are trying to go down the walls to get to the center. Because they feel like they will lose if they won't get to the center in time. No, they are broken. Archers. So they have 7, 7, 3, 10. So 7 melee, charge bonus 3. So total attack in melee is 10. And missile attack 7, and total defense 10. And no special abilities because this is just an archer unit with an armor upgrade. So they had too many elven units, so some of the cool ones had to be armor upgrades instead of an actual unit on their own, like this one. It probably was a unique unit for one of the many high elven factions in the Sundering, but instead they became an armor upgrade here. Really cool unit with spears and melee and bows too. Alright, so the battle at the walls here is about to get won. They're about to win that battle. They still have some high elf spears on the walls fighting our witch elves of Cain. They are probably running now, broken. Good. There are other unit of witch elves fighting the warriors of Blackwood. But yeah, we will win that too. And we don't really need to continue, but we could do that. I enjoy killing everyone. Still have some guys to kill. The wall. The Warriors of Blackwood are routing, that's why we won. We could have ended the battle. They still have some troops here, but they are broken. Yeah, I really like these models. They look so good aesthetically. So all my witch elves on the walls, move down and take care of that unit. And you can hunt down those Blackwood units. Down from the walls and attack them. So Morathi herself didn't get to enter the city this time. This, by the way, is the model used by the beginning of the end time sorceresses, while these are the ones from Warhammer Online or the Sundering. Alright, then we have Morathi. It's the fourth level, the third level of sorceresses, actually, the silver upgrade. So that's Morathi herself. I won't play as her because the battle will be won. We won't need to play as her this time. Okay. Let's move the Manticores out of there. Prevent the timer from running down. The AI ally might still hold the center. So we moved our troops out. Let's see here. I will leave to the infantry to clean up the city. They are moving troops here. Dread Spears. Where are we? There are no enemies here. There are some enemies in the center now. Two units of High Elf Spears. We have some Blixwards here. That will easily handle them. We also have some Witch Elves following them. The ones I sent out from the walls. I desire the rush of the kill. Alright. So, kill them with pleasure. So she has the same unique ability as Malekith. Yes, kill them with pleasure, thank you. They have some 7 Warriors of Blackwood as well. At the center. And we will win this battle now. Without having played as Morathi in third person. So this is the zoomed in view if we are not using that feature. And they are dead. Let's see, 100% enemies killed, 12% allies killed. The battle is over. Good job, Witch Elves of Cain. Clear victory. Morathi had 728 men, lost 95 only. Men remaining is 633. Enemies killed 294, very good. General Druhill had 767 men, half the army. Lost 0, very good. Men remaining, all the remaining kill 0, so they didn't even kill anyone. But they did manage to enter the city, as we can see on the minimap there. Alright, so we healed some of our troops after battle, so instead of 12% killed, we have or dead, we now have 6% dead. So after Prince Tyrion had 431 men, he lost all of them, 0 remaining, and killed 142 of our troops. The detailed battle screen. Alright, and let's return to the map. I don't both need my eyes to spot humans. I can smell the filter beast from a mile away. Shavandrel, half-sighted, one-eyed master, waywatcher of the Asrai. I don't know. Right, so we prisoners captured high elves, enemies captured high elf archers, we captured 46 of them. High elf spears, warriors of Blackwood, we can release them, we can ransom them. Or we can execute them, and I will execute them. We are the Dark Elves after all. No mercy. And we can occupy the city. Gold crowns gained from looting 633. Population to be massacred if we sack the settlement. Gold crowns to gain from looting 2535. And 1026 will be killed in the looting. Exterminate population means we will kill 5129, the entire population of Lothern, and the gold crowns gained from looting will be 1268. So we earn more money if we sack it, but we are the Dark Elves, so we will exterminate the population. We also don't want revolts. Enemy army routes, Morathi. Last battle left a few for alive. Yeah, I know that. Resistance is futile. Lothern, good. Now let's destroy their High Elven buildings, the market one, Elven shrine, and the land clearance can't be destroyed, so we're done here. Right, let's see what we can build. I think we will build a port actually, in Lothern. And we will move the army into the city, and merge it. And we will keep a unit inside of the city, probably. We could keep one unit of Dread Spears. The rest of the army will be moved out to face this army. Right, so we're done there. Let's see here. We will face that army now. So General Mephander, he had 4 units of Lothern's Sea Guard. And 2 units of upgraded, with bronze upgrade, armor upgrade, high elf spears. Alright. Let's save the game in case it will crash or something, and we will fight the battle. Start deployment. I love this model. They look great. Alright. You won't control Morathi in third person because it's easier to win the battle without casualties if we control the entire army like this. And yeah, it's more fun to watch probably too. We will control her in battle if we defend in a siege battle and can't retreat. Or if we are attacking a siege battle, and the opportunity arrives. Alright, so let's see here. We have Shades, Dark Shards, and more Shades. Let's group them into one group and put them on loose formation and single line and place them at the front. Right, then we have some Demoness of Slanese. Let's give all those female units the ability to curse their enemies. Replace them with the curse, activate the curse there. And we have the Reaper Bolt Thrower. Let's move it forward. Loose formation. Let's put it on the side. And they don't need the sharpened stakes, they don't have any cavalry. Actually, they could be at the back because they didn't have any cavalry. Alright, and of course the Dreadspears will use the shield wall formation, but they are only 5 units. Same with this unit, the Bleak Swords will use the shield wall, and Black Ark Corsairs doesn't have any unique skill. This is a unit of Organic Executioners, they won't use anything special. Let's move forward, the Cauldron of Blood, closer to the army. And the cavalry could be placed on the side, the Cold One Knights there, and the Manticores, Manticore Riders on the other side. Let's group all the infantry into one group. Fine, like that, and let's place them on in two lines. And the Harpies could also they are cursing good. And of course, Amazons would also do that too. Start the battle, pause the game. So they started on the side here. Have some Lothern Sea Guard here. Pretty good looking unit. Good from the back as well. And they have some High Elven spears as usual. Let's attack it. We will send 5 units of Dread Spears against their High Elf spears. They need a backup, so we'll send the Bleak Swords too, because they were too few. Okay, Anaconda's Amazons could be sent against the other unit of High Elf spears. And then the Black Ark Corsairs could attack the Lothern Sea Guard unit. We have 5 units of Demoness of Slaanesh. They could attack the Lothern Sea Guard together with Harpies. And then we have 1 unit of Witch Elves of Cain that will attack that unit of Lothern Sea Guard. And another one there. And then the final unit of infantry could also attack that Lothern Sea Guard unit. Start the battle. So the siege engine will be set on fire at will. And the Cauldron of Blood will move together with the units that are attacking. Let's move the sorceress forward as well. And put her in loose formation to be safe. They didn't have any range units, so it doesn't matter. So, the Reaper Bolt Throwers are already firing, they have a long range. See them fire. Cultists of Cain are readying their siege bows to fire at enemy. So they are firing these arrows. Good. Alright. Have the archers there. So the infantry is like a mess there. Let's see here. Let's send the archers after them. I don't want them to to just stand there. Let's send the cavalry as well up to their sides there to hunt them down. And let's activate the kill them with pleasure ability that Morathi has. So the battle becomes kind of a mess against the Lothern Sea Guard. Look at the terrain, it looks very different, very odd. Sunset, etc. Long range units have arrived here. Let's just attack. Raids have a long range, they are firing the enemy. Two units of them. Well, the Dark Rush needed a closer range. Here is my cavalry too. Here is the cavalry here. Run them down, called one knight. Move back, I don't want the spearmen to kill you. I like the terrain in this battle, looks very different. Attack, again. Come on, called one knight. Move back, so they won't kill you. They are spearmen after all. Ram those guys down instead. You should run them down, they are routing. Actually, attack those guys. What about my manticores? Where are they? There. I need to see what's happening on the minimap. Let's attack those running guys there with the manticore riders. Actually, attack these guys, they are broken. And the Cold One Knights are running them down there. Move back. Kill those routing troops. And move back, I don't want those Lothern Sea Guard to kill you. They probably have spears too. They don't have any routing troops here. Kill those guys, they are routing there. As for our infantry, let's run those guys down. Some dark shards here. Shades are hunting down the enemy there. So we won this battle easily. Statistics of the battle. Percentage enemies killed 22%. 76% enemies killed. Allies killed 22%. So, Cold One Knights run down those routing troops here. Good. We're done there, the general died, General Merfandir, just a general, a captain, pretty much. The battle is over. Yeah, very unique terrain, I never played in this terrain before. You're being fired at, huh? Let's lose formation. don't know where the enemy is. There we have them. Let's order our long-range units to attack that Lothern Sea Guard unit. They're firing at our Cauldron of Blood. Oh, they are firing now. They're routing those guys. Stop firing and attack this unit instead. Don't fire drill, attack the unit I told you to attack. Idiots. Attack that unit of Lothern Sea Guard. Good, now they are listening. Continue the battle. Kill them. Actually, my cavalry could run them down. So my sorceress have actually used some attacks in this battle. So let's the Reaper bolt thrower as well. Very long range, yeah. Demons shall feast on your soul. Reminds me of Mortal Kombat, the movie. Sanction. Alright. Some dark shards moving up the hill there. Zoom out on the minimap. We have some troops at the border here. They've hunted the enemy down there. The other side of the map. Shades are hunting someone here. I can't see the enemy. There it is. Alright. They won't reach that place in time. So Morathi is once again victorious. 93% enemies killed, 25% allies killed. We don't really need to kill them. We have killed more than 85%, which is required if you want to kill all of them. So clear victory. Morathi had 1270 men, lost only 174 men, and has 1096 men remaining. Enemies killed 494, and 219 additional troops were killed when they were routing. General Mefandir of the High Elves had 769 men and lost 713 men, and 56 remaining, and probably all of them will be taken prisoner to be executed after battle. And they killed 219 men. The detailed stats sticks. And that's it. And both the High Elven armies close to Lothern were defeated. The one defending Lothern and the one outside that came to relieve it. So now we can move both Morathi's and Hellebron's armies towards the other city. I don't remember the name. So, prisoners captured, enemies captured. High Elf Spears, 22 men. High Elf Spears, 45 men. And 4 units of Lothern Sea Guard with 23 men, 20 men. 71 men and 38 men, and we will of course kill everyone. And they are dead. Trait increase, Morathi, merciless conqueror. In battle, this warrior knows no mercy to enemies. +4 dread.